Georgia, man.
Welcome back to Chelsea's Mommy Corner. I want to welcome all who are new to my channel, and I hope you enjoy the topic that we have today. So before we begin, I mean every one of y'all who are tuning in, when you watch this video, please, I'm asking you to join me, go and grab yourself a glass of wine. We're gonna talk a little bit. So this is gonna be and adult mommy conversation about, you know, an experience I had dating somebody. So I need y'all to go ahead and grab your wine, run along, go ahead, I'll be right here. Okay, you got it? You got it? Okay, good. All right, let's get started. I know. I have not posted a video in a little while, but I'm back and we are back to it. But today, I'm coming to you guys with a video that is another experience video. And this is my personal opinion. So I'm not saying this to make anybody feel some type of way or anything, but okay, y'all. Here comes the tea. So this was a very different experience for me because I've always dated people who were from the United States, and I've never dated anybody who was from outside the United States or anything like that. So it was something new, something different. So this guy and I dated for maybe about a month or two. And when him and I dated, I'm gonna start with the cons first. I'm gonna give y'all the tea, and then I'm gonna go into the pros. So the cons were the fact that he was extremely controlling. It was, you know, I don't want you hanging with any other guys. It was, you gotta be in the house by a certain time. You gotta cook. You gotta do this. Y'all, it was like, it was such a high demand. He wanted a lot. And mind you, I said 2 months. Two months me and him were dating. So you already asking a whole lot from me, and we've only been dating for 2 months. Like, I had people tell me, you know, oh, kind of try to stereotype people from Nigeria, which I was like, no, I'm not about to listen to that. You can't put everybody in one category and say this is how people are. But I would be lying to y'all if I told y'all that everything that they told me, it turned out to be true. I was hoping it didn't, but it came out to be true. First, like I said, the first thing was he wanted me to cook all the time. He didn't want me to go anywhere without him. If I went out, he had to be there. If I was at the club, he had to be there. If I was at home, it was what you doing. Like every 5 minutes, it was what are you doing, where are you at, when am I gonna see you again. Like at first, you know, I can't lie, it was flattering. It was like, oh, he wants to see me again. You know, girls like attention. They want their man up under them too and to be spoiled. But at first it was fine, and then it became obsessive. It became, okay, every second of the day you want to know where I'm at and what I'm doing. That's a bit much. Like, I can't deal with that. I don't know about y'all, but I can't deal with that. Another thing that I feel was an issue was the fact that he thought it was okay to be with other people while with me. Like, granted, we were dating, we were not in a relationship, but that was the goal, to date somebody and then, you know, be with them. But he just felt like, I'm like, hey, you know, if you want to openly date, that's fine. But as far as being in a relationship, I'm like, you know, hey, what's your goal in relationship? And he's like, you know, when I date a woman, I want her to basically be my stress relief from the rest of the world. Like, I'm kid y'all now, I'ma tell y'all. I asked him, I said, what exactly do you mean like that? He's like, if I had a hard day at work, I just feel like I should be able to come home to my wife or my girlfriend, and she needs to rub my back, rub my feet, make sure that I'm fed, make sure I'm taken care of, you know, make sure that I'm pleased as far as having sex, as much as I want to have sex. Like, really? Don't bring your weight of the world on me. Like, I get it. I'm all for, you know, when your significant other has a hard day, you're there for them, no doubt. But it just seems like you want to put all that burden on me, and you want to be what you want me to be, what you take your stress out on and your anger out on. I'm not here for that. Like, no, I'm not here for any of that. The other thing was, when we came to just discuss sex, it was, I don't want to wear condoms because that make me nut fast. I've never heard that in a day in my life. Now, if you got some good without a condom, it's gonna make you nut fast. But I ain't never heard a day in my life that somebody says if they use a condom, they're gonna nut fast. Never have I heard that. So no, like, once these signs started showing and he started showing me these different things that I find to be crazy, it was like, no, backtrack. I'm not dealing with this. You want too much. You want me to give everything, literally everything I have to you. And you want me to also just be out here willy-nilly, and if we get pregnant, all this different stuff, just be cool with it? Like, no. He told me that out of everybody in his family, the person with the least amount of kids is a cousin of his or something. She has 6 kids. Hey, bro. I'm not having 6 kids. I'm not having more than 4. So you might want to back on out of this now. I'm not about that life, okay? I'm not. His idea was, you know, once you get married or once you find a serious girlfriend or boyfriend, you just don't use any forms of protection, and however many babies you have is however many babies you have. I'm not cool with that, okay? I'm not cool with that. Not gonna happen. I wasn't down with that. After the first month, it was, I want you to meet my mom. I'm in love with you. I love you so much. Like, whoa, whoa, whoa. We just met, okay? What do you mean you love me? It's one thing to say, damn, I love your personality. Or one thing to say, dang, I love the way you carry yourself. But say you love me after 1 month? How, Sway? How? No. Moving on, let's talk about the positives. So the positive part of dating this guy was, for 2 months I didn't have a care in the world. It was, you want to go out to eat? Do you want me to get you this? I can get your nails done. We can go out. Here's my car. You can have whatever you want. Now, granted, I'm not a materialistic person. You know, I have my own. I don't need you to do any of that for me. It was nice. But, and I'm not trying to sound ungrateful or anything, it was really nice. Like, that was real good. I was well taken care of. I didn't have to worry about nothing. But all of the other stuff that he came with, it wasn't worth it. It was not worth you being controlling and all over me. And then, actually, to backtrack, he believed that, you know, being his woman, I don't know if this is, you know, everybody, all the guys from Nigeria, but him in particular, he wanted it to be where, you know, your woman, she eats. He was attracted to a heavier set woman. So my mindset is, why didn't you go get you a heavier set woman? No, in his mind, he wanted me to become heavy set. He's like, I like my woman to look like she being fed and have, you know, a lot of meat on her bones and different stuff. I'm not anorexic by any means. I'm not a girl who's, you know, teeny tiny. I'm not teeny tiny at all, y'all. Like, I have weight on me. I got a little bit of a mommy pouch. Hello, like, you want me this big? This big, and I'm not knocking women who are big bone or heavy set or thick or whatever you want to call it, baby. You be whatever you want to be, but don't try to make me something that I'm not. I don't agree with that. I don't agree with, oh, I want you to be real big. And he actually told me, because I know how you were before you got big. I'm attracted to you either way, but now I know you're not going nowhere. You got the wrong one. You definitely got the wrong one, sweetie. So I had to leave him alone, y'all. I had to walk it out. I had to get on out of there. Quick.
Get on out of there. Quick.
Quick. Whew. It took about a month and a half for all that crazy to come out, but I'm happy it did. I just felt like I would talk to y'all about that because I don't know. It was the first experience. Like I said, I've never dated anybody who was not from the U.S. of A. So, I didn't know what I was getting into. I thought it was cool to date somebody from, you know, somewhere else and a different culture and you learn different things. I'm an open-minded person. But once all that willy-nilly wild stuff that is not going to fly with me start happening, no, I had to go. I had to go to the left. He had to go. Look at me, baby. I just want you. I want you, baby. You want that. I just want you. Yeah. Smoke.